In the Dunkirk area of Nottingham, dog handler Stu and firearms cops race to an address after a man allegedly made threats towards his family with a chainsaw.
Man in the building, police officer with a dog. Show yourself now, you've been warned, it's your last chance.
But the potentially dangerous suspect escaped before the cops arrived.
It was just me, mum, little brother and dad, but I don't know where dad is.
And now he's on the loose with a chainsaw and a shotgun. Police crews all over Nottingham, including firearms units, have been hunting the suspect for hours. And now, there's an update.
Just information, that is a black BMW.
The suspect is driving a black BMW X5, and an automatic number plate recognition camera has flagged up that he's in the area.
So now we've got the NPR activation on that vehicle. The BMW, and they've now authorised on status again because this bloke made threats to kill. So it's heading back towards Nottingham.
Stu's gut instinct is telling him that the suspect's driving back towards his family home.
We've got to take it that he's going home for one reason. If he's got a shotgun in the car and he's got his chainsaw in the car that he's already threatened his family with, allegedly, then he's only going to go home for one thing. And we have to neutralise that threat before he gets back to his home address, because the harm that he could do when he gets back with a shotgun or chainsaw, it just doesn't bear thinking about. And we've got to stop him at all costs. Even if it means putting ourselves on the line, we have got to stop him.
Stu's parking off the main road that leads to the family home in his unmarked Skoda that's perfect for surveillance.
If he's coming from the Beeston direction, the most natural way would be along this road in front of us at the moment. If we see him coming down here, then we can give the crews the early edge up.
Minutes later, the suspect's black BMW X5 crosses Stu's path in the rush hour traffic.
It's a near side lane of two.
Stu calls in the sighting to the officer in charge of the operation.
4-3-5, just keep it safe distance and just keep it on the web, please.
He gets the go-ahead to trail the BMW covertly until the firearms crews take over closer to the suspect's home.
Well, obviously, we're going to be looking at a preemptive pursuit
attack to stop this vehicle. Yeah, receive that, sir.
They're taking no chances. A hard-arm stop has been authorised, only used in extreme circumstances. The firearms unit plan to box in the BMW with their vehicles and approach the suspect with guns drawn.
Delta 35, it's approaching the island in the near side lane of three, at the island, committed to the island. Stand by, it's not one, not one, it's the second, and for the team's information, it's got a rear near side light out.
Can we confirm that the subject is driving?
It's hard to tell because his windows are steamed up.
For the hard arm stop tactics to work, they need to wait until the BMW leaves rush hour traffic and the firearms crew are in position. It's up to Stu to keep on the suspect's tail without him noticing.
Delta 35, we've got an offside indication. It's still in heavy traffic.
Stu's keeping the commanding officer updated on the BMW's movements.
Connect this here, we'll drop in behind it.
Yes, got you, Jim.
If the suspect turns right, armed officers are lying in wait and ready to strike with a hard arm stop.
Still offside indication in slow moving traffic, approaching street to the offside.
Yes, we've got behind the subject vehicle.
Firearms officers pull in behind the BMW, and there's no time to waste.
Strike, strike, strike.
Within seconds, the suspect is boxed in.
Oh, please! Switch off your engine! Switch off your engine!
He's held at gunpoint as Stu gets police dog Razor ready as backup.
Put the keys on the room. Step out of the vehicle, show your hands at all times, do you understand? Face those officers to your right.
No wrong, please, stay there.
So far, the suspect's complying.
Well, just keep your hands on there.
What,
you'll come to no harm, mate. It's all right, you understand me?
You're having that up, mate.
But you're back. Come to her off.
The shock of the hard stop is wearing off, and the suspect's getting angry.
What? Shoot that!
Calm down, mate.
Shoot
that!
I found a chainsaw in the car, and also there's a shotgun in the vehicle as well.
The gun's not loaded, it's broken out into its three component parts, so it's safe.
There's relief all round that the suspect and his weapons are off the streets.
It starts to kick off a little bit, but there's no dramas with it. Not injured at all, there's no injuries on the police side, so another good result. And the threat has been neutralised.
After spending time in prison on remand, the man was convicted of affray and possession of a firearm. He was sentenced to a 15-month suspended prison sentence. His shotgun was seized and destroyed. The charges of threats to kill and possession of a firearm with intent to cause fear, to which he pleaded not guilty, were ordered to remain on file. Whilst evading police earlier in the day, he also committed a series of motoring offences and was found to be three times over the drink drive limit. He was disqualified from driving for 36 months and ordered to pay a £140 victim surcharge.